Bless you. God bless everyone. Melissa, that was not the one. It was not it. I don't know what happened to it. That was not it. Hallelujah. God is good. God bless everyone. I am Prophetess Victoria. If you're just tuning on, if this is your first time watching, thank you for watching. If you're catching the replay, God bless you. Watch all the way to the end. Melissa, I want you, hopefully your phone is charged. Let me know when it is an hour past the minute right now. The blessing of the Lord is upon us. Hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It is our hour of empowerment. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Hele brusho kotoro boshanda. Rogos kotoro bokala makasta karabuki. Rokos kotoro boko. Rakas katala bikis kitiri boshondo. Ele mesi tekes itele boshondo roboko. Get your Bible, get your pen and your paper. Hallelujah. Good evening, everyone. Good evening. I'm going to give everybody a few minutes to get on. We're talking about the prophetic. Thank you. We are talking about the prophetic tonight. I want to empower you. God says he wants to reverse the curse. God says that he wants to reverse the curse tonight. You can get your water. We're going to do everything in a condensed, quick manner because I will be off in an hour, okay? So get your water. We're going to do deliverance. God said he want to reverse the curse. I was in my time with God. Hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory. Glory to God. Glory to God. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for invading the presence of your people. Thank you. We just pray, Lord God. Thank you, God. I speak the prophetic blessing over everyone that has shared the broadcast right now in Jesus' name. Everyone that has shared it. Everyone that has gone the extra mile to share the gospel. Receive the prophet's reward right now in Jesus' name. God is turning some things around for you. He's turning some things around for me. He's turning some things around for us. God is turning some things around. I don't know about you, but we need God to turn some things around. Remember, this is the month of supernatural beginnings. So we're in a season where God is going to turn some things around. Everything that is in your life that is not creating a fruitful atmosphere, creating fruitfulness, I command it to be turned around tonight in the name of Jesus. God is turning some things around. The Holy Spirit said, reverse the curse. Like 2 minutes ago before I got on, he said, I want to reverse the curse tonight, prophetess. So that's the vein that we're heading in. The curse is being reversed. In my time with God, like night before last or 2 nights ago, God spoke to me very clearly. I have face-to-face encounters with God, where I have time with God, where he meet with me, where he talk to me, where he tell me what his desire is for his people. Amen? And God told me, I said, God, how do we know that people are completely delivered? How do we know that they're completely delivered? How do we know that they don't need to be delivered again? He said, well, people who are walking in my will, they are completely delivered. People who are walking in their God-given assignment are delivered. They are completely delivered. People who are not, that means that once you get to your fivefold ministry calling, once you get to your place of destiny, it's no longer deliverance that you need. You begin to fight against principalities. Principalities begin to fight your assignment. Principalities begin to fight your purpose. Why? Because the principalities are the powers of the air that try to block God's word from going forth. That tries to block God's agenda from going forth. So God said, The Holy Spirit is an aspect of God too. They all have the same power, the same ability. So you have to make sure that whenever you are doing something, you want to give reverence to God, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit, because they are not the exact same. They all come with a different type of anointing. They all come with a different type of power. God said that it won't always be like this. He's turning it around for you. The Holy Spirit said, reverse the curse. Reverse the curse. So, Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you that everything wicked, everything demonic, everything satanic is being broken off of your people right now. In the name of Jesus, every negative thing is being broken right now off of the people that are listening to the sound of my voice. Speak to your people, Holy Spirit, through the broadcast. Destroy every wicked power. Destroy every principality. Destroy every hindering spirit. Reverse everything negative and turn it into a positive right now in the name of Jesus. God said, some of you all, he's turning you around quickly. He's putting you in a new direction. He's shifting things concerning your life. He's moving you into another playing field. He's putting you from where you used to be to where you should be. He said he's turning it around for you right now. Turning it around for you. I should be seeing, I receive it. I should be seeing that coming across the screen. Because you don't take lightly when a prophet come and speak a word over your life. You have to reach for that thing. You have to take hold of the promises of God. Amen? You have to take hold of the promises of God. It's too many times that people are sitting in a service and the word that they need is being said, but they just sitting there dumb, retarded, not moving, because the enemy is stopping you from receiving. The enemy is hindering you from receiving the word that God is speaking over you. You have to literally receive it. Just like you literally, in order to get to heaven, you literally have to confess Jesus as your Lord. Whenever a word comes forth that belongs to you, you have to receive the word. If you don't receive it, then you're missing out on the anointing that has the ability to transform your whole entire life. Don't let the enemy steal you, rob you of your destiny. Don't let the enemy rob you of what belongs to you. You have to learn how to receive a prophetic word. You have to learn how to take it, how to snatch it out the hand of the enemy. Because when we release it, it's being released into the atmosphere for those who receive it in the spirit realm. But those that sit there playing, not understanding that the power of God is visiting you right now, then there is no change. Change come when you receive what God is bringing you. Change come when you receive what God is giving you. Change come whenever you take it upon yourself to say, God, I snatched that thing out of the heavens for my life. I want something new. I want everything to manifest that you have for me. But as long as you sit there and don't pull on an anointing, then you will go home the same way. You will stay in the same position. No change will come. You have to claim it. You have to receive it. The woman with the issue of blood, she didn't receive the breakthrough because she watched Jesus. She didn't receive it because she watched Jesus. She received it because she tapped into that anointing. She received it because she pulled in on that anointing that was even on the clothing that Jesus had on. That's how you receive an anointing. You press into that grace. You pull on that anointing. You claim it for yourself. When prayer is going forth over you, you claim it. You pull on it. You grab what you need. God is releasing it to you. Let every satanic attack be reversed. Let every devil that is hindering your tongue, hindering you from understanding how to receive, be destroyed by fire now in the name of Jesus. You've been in a low place long enough. You've been going through long enough. Learn how to press your way in. Pull your way into that new level of the glory of God. Pull your way into that new place in God. You got to pull your way in. If I just lay down in the bed while, like my daughter, she's already talking about Christmas. So I know that gifts are manifesting because she's a prophetess. She has the same grace as me. She's already talking about Christmas. Well, if Santa Claus, she's 4 years old. If he's passing and she's laying in the bed, she will never get what is in his package for her because she's sitting there. She didn't tap into it. So you have to learn how to tap into what God is releasing in the atmosphere concerning you. You have to learn how to pull on that grace. You have to learn how to pull on that anointing. Victory belongs to you. But Jesus is not going to shove it. He's not going to shove it in your face. He want to know, are you ready? He want to know, are you ready? He want to know, can you receive it today? Can you receive that he's taking you into new territories? He want to know, can you receive that he's moving you into a new grace? Hallelujah. He want to know if you can learn how to respect what the Holy Spirit is bringing you. It's not about me. It's about the mantle that I carry. It's not about anything else but the prophetic mantle, because that is what will change your life. So you have to learn how to receive. You have to learn how to sit in the presence of God, because that's where prophets are. We represent God in the earth. And you have to learn how to receive from that grace. Learn how to receive it. I'm releasing it to you as I'm speaking. I'm releasing new levels in the glory. I'm releasing favor over your life. I'm releasing healing into your mind. I'm releasing healing into your thought life. Broko, turn it around now, God. Turn it around now. Whatever it is, every lie is being made a truth. A truth. Every lie the devil is sending concerning you, God is turning it around to a truth established on the covenant of who Jesus is. Right now, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We don't serve a dead God. We don't serve a God that can't answer. We don't serve a God that don't understand. We don't serve a God that don't know what we're going through. We serve a God that wants the best for us. But he's not shoveling it to you. He wants you to pull on it. He wants you to claim it. He wants you to speak it out. He wants you to snatch that thing out of the heavens. The Holy Spirit is tired of you not getting what he wants you to have. He's tired. He's tired. He don't want you to keep on living life the same way. It's not the will of God. It's not the will of God for you to keep living the same way. It's the will of God for you to receive that turnaround and walk into it now. God is giving you a baby, Tabernacle. I've been trying to get in touch with you. God is giving you a baby. Expect it. Before 6 months, you'll have a testimony that God blessed your womb. Receive fruitfulness of the womb right now in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, for reversing every curse. Thank you for breaking every stronghold. Thank you for severing every cord. Thank you for destroying every wrong word. Thank you for breaking every word curse. Thank you for scattering every enemy right now by the fire of the Holy Ghost. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Eshiketele boshondo. Regedere shitiki asanda. Dolo moshokotoro broshanda la brekeskete. Thank you, Father, that victory belongs to you. And we press into your grace, God. We press into your power, God. Knowing that you can do anything but fail, God. God just told me that it's about five of y'all that the anointing over your life is changing right now. The anointing over your life is changing. That means that you're already walking in your grace. You're already walking in the power of God. But he says right now he's giving you more. He's giving you a new level. He's allowing you to unlock wealth concerning your divine assignment. He's allowing you to unlock the secrets regarding your divine assignment. God is giving that right now. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory, glory, glory. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Fill him with your power right now. Fill him with your strength right now. Fill him with the life of God, the Zoe, right now, Father, in the name of Jesus. All things new. The Bible says that the kingdom of heaven suffered violence, but the violent take it by force. That means you have to learn how to snatch some things out of the hand of the enemy, because he don't have any problem taking what you're building. Satan don't have a problem trying to destroy what God is doing in your life. He don't have any problem causing you to cry at night, pulling you out of the presence of God. He don't have any problem trying to, everything that you're building, trying to snatch it out by being a distraction in your life. He don't have a problem doing that. So why do you have an issue pressing in and declaring and decreeing? Don't have an issue with it. Don't have an issue with being able to pull on what God has for you. Just pulling it out of the heavens. Don't have a problem snatching it out. You can't be wimpy. The Holy Spirit keeps saying it on my broadcast. You can't be wimpy for the kingdom. You got to learn how to snatch some things. Many people, I just released a book of prophetic fire that changed your life. It's on the website. And the Holy Spirit was ministering to me while I was writing this book. And It's just confessions. It's about 40 confessions, maybe. And it's fire prayers that will change your life. And what the Holy Spirit told me, he said, this is the thing with Satan. Satan understood that he could not advance his kingdom in the heavens. So God kicked him out. Because anytime you are higher than the spiritual authority that God has given you, you're already at a point where you can fail. Because you can never be higher than the anointing you sit under. You can never be higher than the anointing you sit under. And Satan was in heaven trying to promote his own agenda over the agenda of God. And so he was completely out of place. God had already given Satan a great assignment over the worship. He had the highest assignment. Worship is what bring miracles into God, the people of God's lives. Worship is what bring release anointings, release glory. Is what changed your whole entire life is worship. And Satan, he was in charge of that. And he thought that he could be greater than God. And so God said, you want something that I have not ordained for you to have. So you have to go. And so he sent his warring angel. He sent his warring angel, Michael, to kick him and everyone else that he was trying to poison their mind concerning God. He wanted the angels to think that they could actually be above God. You cannot be higher than the anointing you sit under. It's not spiritual order. Whenever your spiritual parents, and I was sharing that today, and Prophet Passion, my spiritual father, he was on there today, and the Gospel family, they were on there today, and they were talking about spiritual authority. And God was speaking to me yesterday about that, and the day before about spiritual authority, about making sure that you understand that when your man or woman of God come to speak a word to you, you don't have time to give your own opinions. Learn how to silence your voice. Learn how to be quiet. Because if you were there already, you wouldn't need them. God send people in your life for you to listen. It may be hard what you are getting at that moment, but you have to learn how to be quiet. You have to learn how to receive. Because if you're sitting under that anointing, then that anointing is already where you need to be. So it's a time for you to talk and a time for you to be quiet. You taught on the very thing Sunday. Hallelujah. God is doing the same thing. He's doing it. He's changing. He said he wants to establish respect back to the fivefold ministry because so many people have been perverting it and doing the wrong thing that people don't respect the anointing. People take the anointing light. You cannot take the anointing lightly. When God is giving advice to you from somebody that is a general in the spiritual realm, you shouldn't have a word. You shouldn't have your opinion at all. First of all, their time is too precious to waste with you telling your own opinions, because if you were there already, then you don't need them. Then maybe you need to go somewhere else. You need to go somewhere else because you have to learn how to sit under that anointing that God has given you. You have to learn how to respect that anointing. You have to learn how to take what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. Because when somebody who is your spiritual parent, who is a general in the army of the Lord, release something to you, you're missing the whole point. You're missing it. Because, well, Satan was a bastard. He was a bastard. I heard a great prophet, a great man of God, he was calling Satan a bastard. It's not a wrong word. Satan wanted to be greater than God. So he left God from God being his fathering. He left from God being his covering. So what is it that you become a bastard when you don't have a covering? You become ostracized. You don't have a certain grace whenever you don't have a covering. It's a real word. It's real. It's not nothing for you to be, oh, wow, because you're saying worse than that. But that's what happens when you leave that spiritual covering. Then you are going off into a field by yourself where you can be attacked by wolves. So you have to learn to sit down, to glean under the anointing that God gives you to sit under. You have to learn how to respect that anointing. Because if you don't, you are allowing calamity to hit your home. Because God is speaking through that person. You're missing the whole point. That person is not coming to give you opinions. That person is giving you the word of God for you. He's giving you the word of God for you. When I come and speak a word to you, I'm not even doing it. Victoria is not speaking. It is God, the Holy Spirit, speaking through me to get you to a new place. And if you have a rebuttal, if you have a comment, if you have your own thoughts, well, then you're rejecting what God is telling you. You're rejecting it because God is talking. So you have to learn how to respect what God gives you. And I wanted to speak on Samuel, 1 Samuel chapter 10. That it says, then Samuel took a flask of oil and he poured it on his head. Samuel was anointing Saul because the people wanted Saul. Samuel had became old. The people wanted Saul. They wanted a king. And so God said, no. He says, if they want a king, give them a king, because this is what their king is going to do. Their king is going to take from them. So whatever you reject what God is giving you, then it's going to be another covering that you will sit under that will destroy you. It will destroy you. It will hinder you. So whenever God give you a covering, when you find that person that can preach you into a whole nother place, that can prophesy you into a whole nother level, you have to learn how to respect that grace. Because if you don't, you're allowing hell and calamity to come into your house because you're rejecting God. You're not rejecting the person. You're rejecting the office of that person. And God does not play concern in the office. That's why some people are going through hell. Because you are rejecting the anointing when you put your own opinion. You don't have an opinion. You don't have an opinion. Saul didn't have a choice but to receive this anointing. God sent Samuel to pour this anointing out over him. And he said, he poured it on his head and he kissed him and said, is it not because the Lord has anointed you commander over his inheritance? When you have departed, and this is prophetic instruction. So God is saying the people wanted man. So Samuel, he was a prophet and he was the high priest. He was making things change, making things happen. We see before that give a one. We see before that the people, when they went to war, when Samuel prayed, it changed things for them. The people got scared, but God spoke based on what that anointing that Samuel had was doing for the people. It said that they heard their enemies coming to them. And they got afraid. And Samuel began to pray for them. And God came out of heaven and spoke behind what Samuel had did. God came and spoke behind. So whenever you respect a mantle that God has given you, the anointing that you sit under, whenever you respect that, then you're allowing God to speak in on your situation. You have to understand spiritual order. And so everything that Samuel did, when Samuel gave offerings, when Samuel prayed, and that's what happens in my ministry. Whenever I go and I intercede for these people, for my partners, for the people that sit, you know, under my anointing, heaven speaks. I just say a prayer, but heaven speaks after that. And so God is showing you the power that he has put in my anointing. But if you miss it, you miss God. And so the people began to desire a king. Saul didn't have that bloodline. Saul didn't have what Samuel had. Samuel was trained by God himself. But then if you go into a covering where man wanted you, you get crushed by certain things, by certain experiences, because they don't have the same anointing that the other person that you had carried. But you got easily offended. But you were growing. But you were learning. But you was receiving what God wanted you to receive. So you can't just be easily move. The Bible says that offenses will come, but offenses come to make you stronger. They come to show you who you are and what you're made of. That's what it come for. It's not for you to get hot, get, you know, all bent out of shape whenever somebody tell you a word of correction, because correction is for the believer. Amen. It's for the believer. Now the child can't correct the parent. Okay. Even your children. God had me teaching about that at church Sunday. Even if my child is 20, which he is, he cannot come and give me his opinions whenever he thinks that something that should be done a different way, because he don't have the grace that I have. Now, if I ask him for his opinion, that is different, but I don't have to take it. I'm just asking him his opinion. So you have to understand that there is a time to speak and a time to be quiet. Your time to speak is when that anointing is flowing. That's your time to speak, so you can snatch that anointing. But whenever correction is coming, whenever you're being taught, it's time to be quiet so you can learn what you need to learn to get you in that next level. Amen? And so it says right here, it is not because the Lord has anointed, is it not because the Lord has anointed you as commander over his inheritance? So God was giving Saul an anointing. God was giving Saul an anointing, okay? When you have departed from me today, you will find two men by Rachel's tomb in the territory of Benjamin at Zilza. Hallelujah. Help me, Holy Ghost. And they will say to you, the donkeys which you went to look for have been found. And now your father has ceased caring about the donkeys and is worrying about you. So listen to what's going on in scripture. God is anointing. He's anointing Saul. Saul is concerned about everything else. When Samuel is trying to give him the anointing that God has for his timing, it is his time. Many of you, it's your time. He's giving you the word. He's giving you the anointing. He's giving you what you desire. He's giving you what you've been longing for. But the thing is, you have to listen. You have to receive what he's doing. So Saul wanted to be looking after, he wanted to go here and be looking after the donkeys, okay? But he should have been paying attention to what Samuel was doing. So Samuel had to tell him. Samuel began to give him prophetic instruction. He began to tell him, this is what's going to happen as you go further down the journey. This is what's going to happen for you. He said, the donkeys you went to look for, they have been found. Now your father, he's not worried about the donkeys. He's worried about you. And then you shall go on forward from there and come to the terebinth tree of Tabor. There, three men going up to God at Bethel will meet you, one carrying three young goats, another carrying three loaves of bread. So he's giving him prophetic instruction. He's telling you, this is what's going to happen. You're going to go here. I'm going before you. The prophetic is going before you. You need the Bible, period. Get the Bible. If you don't have the Bible, you need it, that, period. That's as far as you need to go with that. But the prophetic will go before you. Open up the door for you. Change atmospheres for you. Windows will open from heaven when the prophetic is released over you, when you receive it, okay? And so it was going before Saul, telling him this is what is going to happen. This is what you're going to see whenever you get there. And so right now, God is sending his word before you, saying that the curse is reversed, that things that used to bother you, they won't bother you no more. But you need to respect the anointing. You need to learn how to receive the anointing. You need to learn how to receive the grace. If I show you something in someone that is not like me, I'm showing you a level of the ability to discern spirits. Come away from those things. Let those things go. I'm teaching you something for the new season. This is a prophetic word for somebody. God is saying, I'm teaching you something for the new season that I'm carrying you in. And your promotion and your ability to grow and expand and move into new territory is based on the instruction that I am giving you, says the Spirit of the living God. He says, he who has ears to hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying to you right now. God have a rhema word for everybody on here. Everyone on here. He say, if you have ears to hear, listen to what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. I am going before you. I am opening doors for you. You have to learn how to respect the territory that you are in. I didn't tell you to respect the territorial demons. I said respect the territory. That means that everywhere you go, there is an assignment. There is a structure. There is a grace in that territory. And if you are called to overcome and to destroy principalities, then before you go to that territory, you need to have some fire prayers released over that. The reason why some people are not prospering in this new land is because you hadn't sent the word, the prophetic word over you. The Apostle Paul says everybody should desire prophecy. Everybody should prophesy. Prophesy to you being a speaking spirit that God has created you to be simply means that you take the word. I teach a class on the website. If you don't know, you need to take the class called Prophetic Utterance. You take the word of God and you prophesy it over your life. That's what he means when he says everybody should prophesy. Everybody can prophesy. Prophecy is a direct word from God. If you can't hear God speaking to you, what you can do is see that word manifesting when it come out of your mouth. The Bible says he sent his word and healed them. God's word, it caused things to shift. In the beginning, God said, let there be, and it came to pass. And understand that God created light. Hallelujah, that was good. That was a very good revelation that Prophet Israel released today. First, God said, let there be light. And then God planted the sun. So that means that if God shed his light on your situation before, then you don't need anything else to shine on you. That means that that word is going to be your light. Remember the word, the Bible says the word is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our pathway. So perhaps you are not praying and releasing the prophetic word concerning that territory when you go into it. Maybe that is the reason. Another thing the Holy Spirit is saying, so first, y'all need to take notes. This is the first thing. You're in that new territory. God has been given divine instruction. He gave some at church Sunday. God is giving you divine instruction for that new land. He has opened up a door for you in a new territory. You have to respect what is in that territory. There is an established order in every territory. When you go in the White House, you're not coming first to speak to Trump. You're going to speak to some secretary or somebody. You're not going to speak to Trump first. You're not going to do it. When you go to your local governor, you're not going to speak to him. You're going to, even the mayor, you're not going to speak to him. You might speak to the secretary first. It's protocol. You are a Christian. God gave you the ability to speak something and it happens. So you need to send your word out before you. And you need to respect the territory that is, you need to respect the authority that is there. Many of you have issues on a job. This is the issue. The reason is because you're not showing respect to the authority that is there. You think you know more than them. And sometimes you do know more than them. But it's not for you to voice that. It's for you to pray that thing through. God, teach them what they need to learn. Because when God was building me and training me in order to be where I am today, he sent me in churches where protocol wasn't established, where order wasn't established, where they weren't sending the word, where they weren't even preaching the word. They was preaching like kindergartners. But I felt the Spirit of God there. I knew that's where I needed to be. I knew that's where I needed to be. And so instead of me running, I began to pray for the leader to go higher because I knew that's where God had me on assignment for that season in my life. I learned a lot of things. There were a lot of things that I needed to learn from them, and there were some things that they needed me to pray through for to manifest in their life. So you have to understand, God don't send you in certain territories, in certain areas, in certain levels for you to go and voice all your opinion. You go to God. You tell God what the situation is. You tell him what needs to be changed. You don't send that to your boss, because then the boss think you know more than them, and they want you out the building. Go ahead, Holy Ghost, help somebody, because I don't have no notes. I don't have notes. The Holy Spirit don't allow me to have notes like this. He give me notes right before I'm going to speak a word. That's when he give me notes. And so, like, immediately, like Sunday on the way to church, he was giving me notes. Because I trust the Holy Spirit to provide the word for those people that will be there. If I prepare a word on Wednesday for people who's going to be at church Sunday, them that word is dead by the time Sunday get here. That's not a rhema word from God. That's not setting anybody free. That's not helping anybody. You need to learn how to trust the Holy Spirit to give you what you need in that situation for those people that he is sending you to. Don't go with your own ideas. You need to go empty. You need to learn how to go empty and hear. And whatever you hear that is not correct, you bring that thing to God. It's the same thing in relationships. God allowed me to, you know, help other people, help relationships. And he speak that a lot. Don't go complain to your husband all the time. Nobody want to hear that. Nobody want to hear that. Nobody want to hear your mouth. The Bible says that a woman who complains all the time is like a leaking faucet. It's a nuisance. Nobody want to hear your mouth. Hush. Be quiet. Hush. This is for some wives out here that y'all having problems in the home. Be quiet. Learn how to be quiet. Learn how to pray to God to change the situation. Learn how to be quiet. He won't let that thing go. Learn how to be quiet. Learn how to be quiet. I said, learn how to be quiet. Whenever I go in the presence of Jesus, it's a protocol Jesus wants me to follow. He wants me to pray in the Holy Ghost, and he's going to start speaking. Whenever is my time with God, I have face to face with God. He don't want me to talk. He wants me to sit down and listen. So there is a time and a position that you enter into in every atmosphere you go in. Now, when you're at home looking at TV, that stuff that's not good for you, that's causing you to want above and live above your means instead of watching your credit score and fixing your credit report, you're watching all this foolishness on TV, and then you want to live like they living, and then you're robbing Peter to pay Paul, and then you can't pay your tithes, you can't sow your seeds, and your life is hell, but you look like a housewife of Atlanta, but you don't have $1 million in your bank account. The devil is a lie. That's not right order. That's not right. That's foolish. That's the lust of the flesh is what it is. That's the lust of the flesh. It's the lust of the eye. It's the pride of life. I'd rather have my bills paid and go get me a $29.99 something else than go pay $500 on something, but I can't, my credit score is 450. That is deceit. That's what's wrong with the body of Christ. God wants us to build our credit. God wants us to have knowledge of some things. God wants us to know what is going on at all times. You don't need to go apply for a loan if you never pulled out your credit score to see what it is. Because every time you go and you pull that, you get somebody to check your credit, even if it's for a denial, they are killing your credit score even more. Get wisdom concerning where you're going. It's a protocol. You know you want to go get a loan? See, because some people don't know this. Because I had to find it out for myself. So I want to help. I want to help. Yes, it does. And it takes 2 to 3 years for those things to fall off your credit report. It lower it. You need to have wisdom in what you're doing. Have wisdom. Don't jump into no situation thinking you can do something. The Bible says that whenever you build your house, you got to count the costs. Whenever you're about to do something, you got to figure out what is it going to take to be maintained there. Otherwise, if you didn't sit down and think about the cost, figure out how everything is going to look, then when something hit you, she said it takes 7 years to fall off. But whenever something hit you, then you devastated, but you wasn't prepared for the territory that God took you in. But whenever you pray the word over your life, the word goes before you. Let me tell y'all, a lot of people think that God is not answering them prayers. But God is answering your prayers. You're praying for wealth. You're praying for wealth, and God is teaching you how to save. He's teaching you how to tithe, how to give, and you never did those things before. He's already answering your prayers. He's already showing you what it's going to take. You just think that because you're praying for wealth and he didn't send somebody to send you $1,000, you think that he's not answering. No, he's teaching you something. Don't despise the small beginnings. Don't despise them. If I'm praying for $1 million, God has a protocol for that. I better make sure I'm on point with my giving, with my tithing, with my confessions, because your confession is going to get you there. They are going to get you there. But it's steps to this. It's a protocol to this. God told Abraham, this is what I'm going to give you. Look out. Your seed will be numbered as the sand. But Abraham had to have a vision for that. If you can't go, and I told my best friend, I said, I know you're going to get that house. I know you're going to get it because you've been writing a vision for your house 7 years. So where is she now? Now she's to the point where she's sitting down. She knows everything that's on that credit report. She knows exactly what it's going to take to cancel that debt. She got a plan to put money aside to cancel that debt. And when she go to get that house, she's not hitting and missing. No, it's like the Apostle Paul said, when you fight, you're not fighting with the air. No, you landing them punches. You are defeating them giants. Look at this devil. You better worry about if you're going to heaven or hell. Go sit down. It's as real as you can see it. Hallelujah. And it's glorious and it's beautiful. So she's not hitting and missing. She's hitting that devil dead on the head. When she go, she had her work done. Everything is prepared. All they can do is say, ma'am, how much money do you need? It's an order to this thing. It's an order to everything. Everything has to be done decent and in order. So don't get frustrated whenever, you know, always evaluate. Always examine yourself. Always examine what you could be doing different. The enemy come to show you who you are. When he's fighting against your marriage, that means God has given you a grace and a level of the anointing that you can pray hell out of your life. If you go through hell in your marriage, you have an anointing to pray hell out of situations, because you should be praying hell out of your marriage. And when you see what God is going to do this turnaround season, then you're going to know the power that God has already given you. And so whenever God say, now go preach my word, you already ready, because you were praying to go into that wealthy place to preach the gospel, but God was training you how to manage your home. See, God will train you in every and any situation if you'll listen. If you're not listening, you'll miss it completely. You'll want something before it's time for you to get it. And then when you get it, you don't know how to handle it. Because the other day God said, if they don't know what to do with $10, if I give them $1,000, they will miss the $1,000. And if I give them the $1,000,000, they will completely fail at the $1,000,000. It's stewardship. God is giving you wisdom. He's reversing the curse. Some emotional things were done in your past. You moved based on emotion. But now God says in this new territory, you're moving based on his word. You're moving based on the prophetic word going before you. And so you have to land dead on. You're not going to hit and miss. You're going to make it. You're going to be greater on this next side. Everything is going to be easy for you because God is giving you wisdom in the low place for the high place. But it's protocol. Number one is you have to respect what is there. Respect that anointing. Respect what is there. If the boss say you shouldn't do this, well, they signing your check. So unless you have another alternative plan, you better do it, baby, because that's what it's going to take for you to keep that job. That's wisdom. You don't. The Bible calls it kicking against the pricks. That's what Jesus said when he came to Saul and made him Paul. Why do you kick against the pricks? Why are you going against the very thing that I created, is what Jesus was telling him. I created order. I created structure. I created a system for people to be saved. Why are you persecuting that system? God blinded him. Had to send him a prophetic word through another man of God that was listening to the voice of God in order for his sight to be restored. Some of you all, God is removing the scales off of your eyes concerning wealth, concerning healing, concerning why you are going through calamity in your life right now. And immediately, your life is shifting through the word of God. Through the rhema word, your life is shifting. Things are changing immediately. Whenever that word go forth, it's power in that word to change things, to change circumstances. And so Samuel, he poured that all out on Saul, and he told Saul, when you go here, it's going to be some people here. Chapter 10, verse 3, 1 Samuel. Then you shall go on forward from there and come to the terebinth tree of Bethel. The terebinth tree of Tabor. And three men are going up to God at Bethel. Will meet you, one carrying three young goats, another carrying three loaves of bread, and another carrying a skin of wine. And they will greet you and receive and give you two loaves, which you shall receive from their hands. Now listen, the prophet even had to tell him to receive what these men are going to give you. That shows right there that he had a problem receiving. He had a problem receiving. The prophet told him, this is where they're going to be. This is what they're going to be doing. This is what they're going to have. And this is what you do when you get there. So it is of God for the prophet to tell you how to behave, how to look, how to act, how to dress, what to do. It is of God. It's protocol. God is trying to get something to you. Don't be offended. Don't be offended. Some people have to teach you something that you can't see for yourself because they've been there. Because God is giving them the ability to see. Eshiketelebo. Rokosko Torobo Shanda. Brekeskete. He said, take it from their hands, receive it. After that, you shall come to the hill of God where the Philistine garrison is. And it will happen when you have come there to the city that you will meet a group of prophets coming down from the high place. Now, the prophet is telling them you're going to meet the prophets, okay? And he said, when a group of prophets will be coming down from the high place with a stringed instrument, a tambourine, a flute, and a harp before them, and they will be prophesying. So that says that there is a sound that comes before the prophetic. There is a sound. People try to tell you people are manipulating the atmosphere and all this other retarded stuff about music, but there is a sound that goes before a prophetic word. Heaven is released. You hear the trumpets sounding before the prophetic word. And it says that the prophets were coming with the sound. The prophets were coming with that sound, he said, and they will be prophesying. Then the Spirit of the Lord will come upon you, and you will prophesy with them and be turned into another man. A lot of people are hindered because they hadn't tapped into that prophetic grace. That means that I am preaching a word to you, and you sitting there like this. Now, do this mean you're receiving? No, because the cross of your arms mean that you're not receiving. It means that you already know too much. It means that you don't need to be where I am because you're not receiving. This right here, when I was going to college for communications, nonverbal speak more than anything else. Your nonverbal language. It determines 85 to 90% of what you're saying and doing by what your body language is saying. So if you're sitting right here like this in church, you're not receiving nothing. Because when that word that is coming across your head for you to receive it, you sitting there looking dumb. When you should be jumping out of your seat, being baptized, being filled with the Holy Ghost, you sitting there with your face looking long like somebody done died. When you should be overjoyed because you're in the presence of God. Looking retarded. Looking dumb, stupid, retarded. And me, when I feel that power, when I know the power of God is there and I hear the word, because a lot of times the power of God is coming, whenever that word comes forth, that is the power of God. Sometimes you don't need a prophetic word. You need to hear that word being preached. And you sitting there looking retarded, that shows that you're not receiving. See me, I can't sit still when I know God done showed up in the house. I want to jump. I want to shout. I want to receive. I want to pull down. I want to run and jump. You're not going to catch me. I told God, whenever I was going through and seeing my child on a ventilator at 21 years old and did not understand anything, didn't understand nothing, I was confused. I was scared. I didn't know what was going on. I was in a wheelchair even at that point. I didn't even know what was going on. But Jesus came in. I saw Jesus. It was 6 months after I had gotten saved. Jesus came in. Jesus had a briefcase. He told me, I'm going to be your lawyer. I'm going to fight this battle for you. I'm giving you peace. That's what Jesus told me. I said, Lord, because on the way to the hospital, I went bananas crazy, hollering and screaming. I wanted my baby. He was in another vehicle. It was a terrible accident. He was in one vehicle. I had to be driven or I was going to have to wait behind while I was walking on broken limbs. Didn't even know it. 21 years old. And some of y'all are concerned about what you're going through now. And you want to be where I am, but you can't even walk a day in my shoes. So you should be respecting the anointing just because of what I've been through is to get you out of your problems. It's to get you out of your problems. God sent you to me so you don't have to go through it. So just that alone, my testimony alone should be enough to silence you in my presence. So you can learn what it takes to get you where you need to be. Help them, Holy Ghost. Help them. Because they don't know how to receive you. But if you learn how to receive the Holy Spirit, your life will be easy. Your change will be here now. The curse will be reversed. And Jesus told me, I'm going to be your lawyer in the courtroom. I'm going to, because the same day, the exact same day, the same morning, I got in my accident. Another lady had drove her kids and her drunk self into a bayou. So instead of the police going and drug test her, I never been a person who did drugs. Instead of the police going to drug test her, they come in my room in the hospital trying to drug test me when I'm watching my child being pumped with an Ambu bag fighting for his life. I don't do drugs. You can suck my blood if you want. I don't do drugs. I'm not a drinker. You can do whatever you want. I wasn't thinking about it at that time, but I understood what was going on. But they got her. They found her. But Jesus told me, I'm going to be your lawyer in the courtroom. That's the reason he told me that. He's telling me no matter what come up against you, I have you. He's saying I'm going to give you peace in the midst of this. And he did. He fought that battle for me. And so I was going banana slap crazy on the way to the hospital. And then Jesus said, I give my peace to you. And everything, just a calm just came over me completely. Because they was calling the ambulance. I'm remembering they called the ambulance. They wanted somebody to come give me something to put me out. Because I was losing it. I was going hysterical. And then Jesus showed up in the place. I didn't just start walking with Jesus because you just seen me on Periscope. I've been walking with him for a long time. He gave me a grace to pull you out of your problem. He gave me a grace to pull you out of your situation. And it was because I was trained through hardness. I was trained like a soldier and made it through those things. And so he came in. And he gave me peace in the midst of every part of it. He says, I'm going to fight for you. I'm going to do everything that I need to do. I'm going to carry you through this. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you. And so because I was in his presence, I knew that I was prepared. I was being prepared for something greater. People came and they were prophesying to me, oh, something great is coming out of this, something great is coming out of this. And I'm like, I hear what you're saying, but I already heard what Jesus said concerning me. I heard what he said, okay? And so when prophecy is going forth, you better learn how to receive it because you don't know what hell is coming up behind you that you would have needed to receive that word, but you're sitting there trying to be cute, looking dumb, in church, not receiving that breakthrough word because there's prophetic gestures. We do them all the time in my church. I tell them, I said, now you stand up and you stomp on the feet of the devil. It's a prophetic gesture. If I said it, the Holy Spirit told me to say it. That means that you need to be doing it because he sees something ahead of you. It's a prophetic gesture. It's something that you're doing in advance before something takes place. You don't have time to sit in a prophetic anointing and under prophetic grace to sit there hopeless, looking, you know, hopeless and not understanding. No, you receive the word. You receive it. It's no time to study. The prophets right here, they were prophesying. Whenever you experience the prophets, and Samuel told Saul, you are going to be turned into another man. When a prophet speak over you, it's to turn you into a whole nother person. Whenever you experience the prophetic, remember he said there will be a sound. The prophets will come behind and then you will begin to prophesy. I just told y'all that in the beginning. You prophesying is getting that word and declaring it over your life. It will make you a new person. But when you come on these broadcasts and you receive what the Lord is giving you, that is shifting you in the spirit realm automatically. But then it becomes your obligation to stay in that grace. When you get delivered, it becomes your obligation, your responsibility to stay in that grace, to continue to flow in that grace, continue to read the word, continue to pour yourself out before the Lord. We on here at 5 in the morning. We got about 60, 70 people on right now on the two broadcasts. We on here at 5 in the morning. We got about 20-something people. But you texting me all day talking about, can you pray? Well, why you wasn't in prayer this morning? Because when we was up at 5:30 in the morning praying, we already had the answer. You should have been up too. You should have been up too. Okay? God ain't sending me on there for nothing. God is sending me on there for you to learn prayer structure. He's sending me on there for you to learn something for yourself. It's not just about the word. It's about the structure of the word, the order of the word, you understanding what happens in prayer, you understanding that it takes faithfulness, consistency. God is showing you 10 things at once. But instead, you come just to receive. You come just to come to press in. Press in. Thank you. Come to press in, to pull what you need. God, I'm in this atmosphere. I feel your power. Show me how to get it. I'm in your presence, God. Show me how to keep that thing. I got delivered, God. Show me how to hold on to my soul's salvation. Lord, I just, the wind of God, I just felt something just slap me upside my head when the woman of God was talking. Help me to maintain that new grace that you just gave me. Simple. Talk to him like just like that. But you got to learn how to receive the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is not forcing himself on you. He's going to keep on moving. And if you don't receive what he's telling you, you're just going to get missed. You're going to miss out. You're going to miss out. Understand, there's parts in the Bible where the centurion in the Bible is saying that he told Jesus he needed a healing for his household. And he told Jesus, he said, I don't need you to come to my house. I'm a man who tell people what to do. I have people who work under me. I understand that. I understand that if you say something, it's going to manifest. So can you just send your word to my house? And Jesus said, I have not seen anybody else that had that kind of faith. Because he was not begging Jesus to come. He respected the anointing on Jesus' life enough to say, no. You don't even have to move. If you say it, it's going to happen. I receive it. That was faith. That is what faith is. Faith is you coming to the broadcast, you coming to church, wanting a change. That's what faith is. You coming into the broadcast, you doing the work, you sowing, you doing things that will get you in a new place. You have to do things differently. That's what faith is. Faith is cheering your man or woman of God on, praying for them. Because whatever you pray for them, God is changing you. He's changing you. If they are a prophet, then you don't pray retarded talking about, can you just bless them with this? No. Pray that the prophetic mantle grows. Amen. Somebody needed to know that. I don't know who. And then the spirit, verse 6, and then the spirit of the Lord will come upon you and you will prophesy with them and be turned into another man. And let it be when these signs come to you that you do as the occasion demands, for God is with you. Whenever you receive the prophetic word, whenever you receive it, whenever it is coming to you, whenever God is changing your life, whenever the Holy Spirit is reversing your curse, whenever he is doing that, he just said it right here. These signs will come to you and that you do as the occasion demands, for God is with you. And in another translation, he says, you're prophesying with them. You are sitting in this anointing to learn. I'm training you. I'm teaching you. I'm building you for the new place that you're going in. You're already in that place in the spirit realm. You're walking into it now in the natural. He says, and so when you are here, God is with you. God is favoring you. It's nothing that God won't give you that you're asking in this place, because the grace over your life has changed whenever you accompany the prophets. That's what he told Saul. And if you know the story of Saul, you understand that Saul also became bitter later on and came against the anointing of God, who was David, because David was the man after God's own heart. Remember, Saul got bitter, but what happened? Saul left that grace. The Bible talks that Saul was going and doing sacrifices, not waiting on the man of God. God didn't give him that authority. And that's what I was saying earlier. Satan wanted to be God. He starts talking about, we're going to do this, we're going to do that, this is what's going to happen. And God said he got to go. God didn't kick him out. God sent Michael, my angel of war. He sent Michael to go and kick Satan out. And Satan came here, had dominion here. He had a certain level of power here. Let me say that. A certain level of authority here. And God, this is why he fights you so hard. And it's in my book, Fire Prayers. This is why he fights you so hard. And we're going to go. Satan fights you so hard because he left heaven mad. He thought that he was going to be smarter than God. Cunning, okay? He thought that if he took some of God's angels and brought them here, that he could be worshipped. Because he wanted to be worshipped in heaven. He wanted to be God. God kicked him out. God sent him here. But God had a plan. God had a plan to take man and put man in his place in the earth. So Satan thought he was going to have dominion and authority here, but God already had a plan that I'm going to give my same power, my same authority to man. And that is why he will always try to cause you to get out of your assignment, to run from your spiritual covering, to go against the pricks, to kick against the anointing that's training you, to cause you to try to fight when you should really be submitting, because he's trying to get you to resist the authority that God has given you. The only anointing that grows is the anointing that is submitted under a higher power. If you're not submitted under anybody, you will not grow. You will not experience the fullness of God. You have to be submitted to someone. I remember a prophet told me, whenever God told me to leave my other church, they weren't teaching me. I was sitting down. I was meeting God every day. God was training me about the prophetic. The Holy Spirit was training me about the prophetic. He was showing me everything that I needed to know. He told me to leave that church. It became a hindrance to me. It became a stumbling block. Because while God is teaching me, I'm going here. And the pastor don't even know that God is using him like the devil. To talk about the prophetic. Everybody can see in the realms of the spirit, the devil is alive. That's why y'all not healed and delivered and set free over there. But it's okay. God got a place for y'all. But anyway, so God said, come away from there, sit down, sit under my anointing. And he sent me to someone else that could unlock me. And then a prophet came to me in my training season. He came to me and he said, God is about to cause a shift. When you connect with your spiritual father, your whole entire life will change. And then I started praying in my regular time with Jesus, and God showed me, the Holy Spirit showed me Prophet Passion. And I did what he told me to do. And Prophet Passion became my spiritual father. And I started learning. And the anointing that I had, the grace that I had, the things that God was showing me, nobody else understood that. But when he would talk, he was revealing to me the things that God had already said. And that's how I knew that that's where I needed to be. Everybody is not called to be over your life. But the person that it resonates with your spirit, the person that you know beyond a shadow of a doubt that they are changing your life every time they speak a word, that is who God is calling to be your spiritual parent. They change your entire life. They don't even know that they're talking to you. They just flowing with the Holy Ghost. Okay? Some of y'all sitting under some dead anointings. Them people ain't teaching y'all nothing. What are you holding on to? You better let it go because your soul is at risk. You're going through hell because you're not learning how to be a good soldier in the army of the Lord. Because where you're sitting, they don't have a grace to take you where you need to go. But God sent a prophetess, Victoria, to come on the Facebook page. I have a grace for media. I could be at church preaching on location. But he told me, I have to go on here on Wednesdays to teach his people, to train his people. And so I've been here for quite some time on Wednesdays. I used to come on different days of the week, but I know since the beginning of the year, at least, it's been every single Wednesday. It used to be every, like, in the morning time. But anyway, God have an order. God have a protocol for you. You have to sit under an anointing to grow. God will show you where you need to be. He'll tell you where you need to be. You have to be established. You have to be established. You have to have that foundation. Because Jesus didn't do nothing apart from the Father. The Holy Spirit, I told y'all, the Holy Spirit said, well, whenever, I don't move aside from what Jesus is doing. Now, will the Holy Spirit manifest and show different revelation here? Of course. Because it's not everything the Holy Spirit did, it can't be written in the Bible. It is not enough room in the Bible. But if you listen, and you read the word, the things that the Holy Spirit is saying to you in your spirit, it will be structured just like the word of God. It's not going to be apart from what Jesus did. It's going to be the same foundation. It's going to be established on the same principles. But whenever you sit under an anointing and you respect that anointing, you grow. You become everything that God had. So many of you, the Holy Spirit wants you to know that I'm answering your prayers. I'm changing you. As a person, God is going to change you before he put you in your garden. See, because Adam didn't know Adam. Adam just was walking in the blessing. He didn't know who he was. Satan came to reveal to him, look, you got a lot of power. You got a lot of authority. You have a lot. Why? Because he tried to steal it. He tried to rob him of it. Anything the devil is trying to pull you from, telling you, you don't need to know, you don't need to go to church, you don't need to listen, you don't need to sow, you don't need to give, then that is a sign that you are just where you need to be. That's a sign. Because the enemy will try to rob you of your wealth, inheritance, your financial blessings by teaching you that you're not supposed to sow. But the Bible says you're supposed to sow and give. The devil is a lie. You have to understand what God is doing. Because when the enemy come, if you don't have a word and know what that word say, then he can pull you out a little bit. And thank God that I'm on here often enough that you can come back and you can listen and you can get corrected in your error and in your mistake and in where you're missing it. So the first thing you're going to do, you're going to have to respect the anointing that you're sitting under. You go to work, you got a boss. You have to respect it. If they tell you to do something, and I'm going to tell you, last year in August, you have to do things in order, decent and in order. There's a season for you to pray about some things, and there's a season for you to speak out. When you're still learning, you're still growing, it's not time for you to speak out. God will tell you when it's time to make a noise, to make a sound, to be heard, to be seen. He'll tell you. But other than that, you're supposed to be in the back doing the work of the Lord and praying and praising your way through. Go on bookprophetess.timetap.com, or you can go on prophetessvictoria.com and you can set up a one-on-one on prophetessvictoria.com or bookprophetess.timetap.com. And so you can pick your own schedule, your own time, based on what I have open. And so, let me block her. Y'all was telling y'all, see, y'all taught me something that there was some trolls on here. I have to learn how to block them naked things. That don't make no sense. You're on there naked. Anyway, so you respect the anointing that you're sitting under. You receive the word when you get in that grace. You receive what you need to receive. So it's twofold. It's on your job in secular society, and it is in the realms of the spirit. You receive. And then God will build you. He will give you your own revelation based on the revelation of that person. Prophet Passion go very deep concerning some things. Angels and demons and different things like that. And then when I sit down with God, God showed me so much more. Because he had to unlock me to a certain extent so that whenever God speak to me about my grace, I would know that, okay, God is just expanding it more, giving me more revelation because of my time studying. And that's what it is. The devil wants you to try to be... This is how you know you learn. Whenever you can duplicate it, that means you learn something. Whenever you can do what I did, that means you learn something. Whenever you can demonstrate who I am, when you start looking like me, you start doing things like me, then you're receiving. I love when I go down Facebook and I see my spiritual children posting. I see them posting about God. I see them giving God praise and giving testimonies. It shows me that they are learning. Look at this retarded here. Glory to God. So learn how to respect the anointing. Learn how to receive. Okay? That's the only two things you need. And the curse is reversed. The problems you've been having, you won't have them anymore. Okay? You won't have them anymore. So right now, get your water. And we're going to go. We're going to be quick. So hurry up. You should have it already. Anything that has hindered your divine assignment, I'm tearing that down right now. Anything that has hindered your divine assignment, the curse is being reversed right now. Anything that has hindered the path that God has for you to, even you talking too much. If your man of God or your woman of God sent a word, be quiet, receive the word, pray over the word, period. Nothing else. Nobody have time to go back and forth with you. Maria, I see angels around you. They're imparting something to you right now, Maria. The angels are around you imparting something to you. You are one of the people that, when I said at the beginning that God is giving you a new grace, you are one of those people. Maria Duffy. Me too. Everything that's spiritually dead, and you one of them. Spiritually dead. You better learn how to get with Jesus before you end up in hell. You spiritually dead. Broko sotolo boshanda la brigeske tere boshondo. Brakaskatara besende. Okay, stretch your hand toward the screen. Broso koto toro bo shanda la bregeskete, danda la bresegede shiki asakata la besende, robo shokoto lo bo shanda la meke sende, robo shoto lo boko. God is turning some things around for you right now. The power of the Holy Ghost is going through the broadcast right now. Ele breshe dege sende le broshoko brashakata la mashanda, I deshete tere beke sete le boshondo. Broko, baggage is falling off of some of you all. You've been carrying too much emotionally. Baggage is coming off of some of you all right now. Just keep your hands stretched toward the screen. Ele brosho godolo boshanda la bregeskete. Brata kala bashakata tatara beshende de beshete didi shiti atala boko. Broko skotoro boshanda la bregeskete de boshondo. Braka sata tatara beshende. Robo shokotolo boshanda bregeskete de boshondo. Broko, some of you all, God is releasing new virtue in your life. God is teaching you what it means to live holy. God is just transferring the anointing right now for you to learn what holy living is, so that you won't be hindered going forward. In the name of Jesus. If you just want to stretch your hand toward the screen. The Holy Ghost fire is being transferred to some of you all right now. Holy Ghost fire. The fire of the Holy Ghost is being transferred right now in the name of Jesus. Fresh oil to get wealth. I saw about 7 people on Periscope, 4 people on Facebook. Fresh oil to get wealth. The angel is transferring that anointing right now. I release the fire of God over you right now, woman of God. I command the fire of God to go and overtake you right now. Overthrow everything in your life that is not of God, where you will be in a new level of grace, a new level of fire. I loose the fire over you right now in the name of Jesus. The fire of God, touch her right now in the name of Jesus. He shakatala besende, roboko, rabakasanda, deshikititi shiti andalabo, roboko sotolo moshanda. God is sending peace. It's a couple of y'all that your thoughts is all over the place. Your mind is all over the place. Your life is all over the place. One minute you want to be here. The next minute you want to be there. God is giving you peace. He's planting you right now. He's planting you right now. He's planting you right now. Anjanette, you are one of them that God is planting right now. Alicia, you are one of them that God is planting right now. You prophetess, Shamia, you're one that God is planting right now. God is transferring a new level of anointing over you, Natalie, right now. A new level of the anointing over you right now in Jesus' name. Keep your hands stretched toward the screen. God is pulling a lot of pain off of your life, Sandra. Sandra Jones, God is pulling a lot of pain off of your life right now. I see the Holy Ghost fire just all over you. God is pulling pain off of your life, all the suffering, all the strongholds. God is pulling that off of your life right now in Jesus' name. Fund me. We talked today in Australia. God is giving you a wealth anointing right now. God is giving you a wealth anointing. Break here. Well, do it. You just received the fire of God. It's going to be easy for you now, woman of God. Break here. Say telebo. Holy Ghost fire. Break every curse off of their life. I command every demon spirit, every demonic spirit, every satanic spirit that has hindered you from going forward, that has hindered you, every stronghold that is blocking your anointing, I curse it now in the name of Jesus, and I send it back to the pits of hell in Jesus' mighty name. Every spirit of infirmity, I curse you right now and send you back to the pits of hell right now in Jesus' name. You spirit of demolition, the devil has been trying to destroy your assignment. There's many of you, about 15 of you. God is restoring you now in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost fire, touch them now. Touch them now, Father, now in the name of Jesus. God is breaking a spirit of condemnation and crushing off of you right now. Keep your hand stretched. The spirit of rejection is being moved off of you right now. People did not know how to receive you. God said he's giving you a new grace right now, that people will come looking for you in the name of Jesus. Fire of God, everyone that is drawing into this anointing, God, purify them. I destroy and speak against any spirit of retaliation in the name of Jesus. It shall not return. It shall not return in the name of Jesus. It shall not return. You shall not be hindered. The curse is broken. The authority of God is commanding a new level of grace over your life in the name of Jesus. You will hear clearly. You will see clearly. You will flow even with the Lord. You will not go before the Lord. You will not be behind the Lord. You will flow even with the Lord in the name of Jesus. I crush the head of the serpent right now off of your life from hindering you in your calling, from hindering you in your assignment. I break it now in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost fire. Go through the screen, God, right now. Holy Ghost fire. I release the fire of the Holy Ghost. I release the fire of the Holy Ghost. God is restoring right now. Some of you all, God gave you an anointing and you gave it back. You went back to the hands of the devil, but God is restoring you now in the name of Jesus. You will come out of a backslidden state, says the Spirit of the living God. You will no longer backslide. Living for God will be easy for you from this moment forth in the name of Jesus. I break every generational curse of running from your assignment off of your life right now. In Jesus' name, I break every generational curse off of you from running from your God-given assignment right now. In the name of Jesus, I command Satan to loose you and let you go. Every principality that has hindered your assignment, I break it now by the fire of the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' mighty name, I break it. I cancel the assignment. I cancel it now in the name of Jesus. God said you're going to speak in a whole new level. God said that you're going to talk different. Everybody, the generational chains have been broken off of you. You're going to talk different. You're not going to talk with doubt. You're not going to talk in fear. You're not going to talk with terror and calamity. God is breaking that now in the name of Jesus. There are two people on Periscope that's looking for a house. God is giving you that house now. You're looking for, who are you? Who are you? You're looking for a place to stay. God is giving that to you now. Braka, God said, get it. It's for you. Get it. It's for you. God is opening the door now. In Jesus' name. God is a deliverer. Everybody that just received your deliverance, I need you to type, God is a deliverer. God just delivered you from some things that nobody else had an anointing to pull off of you. If you know some things just came off of you, type, God is a deliverer. God is a deliverer. Your obedience to the prophetic instruction is going to keep you delivered in Jesus' name. Broko 8:18 is prophetic. It's prophetic for a new season. It's prophetic for a new grace. It's prophetic for increase. It's prophetic for chains being broken. It's prophetic for God restoring. It's prophetic for God healing. 888 is in today. God is doing new things for you. Hey, Shendele Broso Kodoro Bosho. Braka Satatara Besendele Boko. God said his grace is sufficient for you. You are looking. God said, what I'm giving you, your bank account don't line up, but I'm opening the door. God said, what I'm giving you, your bank account don't line up, but I'm opening up a door. He said, I'm giving it to you. I'm giving it to you easily. I'm giving it to you. He said, you don't have to want for it. You don't have to work for it. I'm giving it to you now. I'm giving it to you now. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Curses are broken off of their bloodline. Thank you that they will hear your voice. They will obey your voice in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Great things happen on today. In Jesus' mighty name. Now, I want you to stretch your water because I think my battery is going to die quickly on Facebook, probably both of y'all. Father, in the name of Jesus, we seal this anointing. We bind up any spirit of retaliation off of this anointing now. In Jesus' name, as they stretch their water toward the screen, we turn it into the blood of Jesus. That the anointing of the blood of Jesus, the power that is in the blood of Jesus, it will no longer bring retaliation. The enemy is blocked. Their firstborn, their seeds, what they do will prosper. It will succeed. It will be established. It will grow. It will multiply. It will increase. In Jesus' name, you can receive your water as a representation of being covered by the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' name. Fresh anointing in your house, Natalie. Fresh anointing in your house. Thank you, Father. God bless you. I'll be back on for Friday Night Live. I think I'm going to remove the Mondays. You sow the seed. Okay, God bless you. Everybody that can, that want to be blessed and get a different grace, they can sow a seed of any amount. I want you to sow it. Everybody that can, that sows a seed, send me a message on Facebook Messenger. And I want to send you my new book of fire prayers. I want to send it to you. So I'm going to give you a code to go on the website. Everybody that sow a seed, type in and say, prophetess, I sold. Danielle, you don't have to. You sold today. Type that in whenever you, if you send a seed of any amount, where will you be in Houston? I sent a flyer. Follow me on Facebook. I don't even know. I don't even know the name of the place. It is in Houston. It's, I'll come back. When I come back Friday morning for prayer, I'll have it up. But I want to send you my new book, Fire Prayers. It's going to change your life. So send me something on there. Oh, it's the 23rd, but I don't remember the location. Send me something, say I sold, and I'm going to give you a coupon code to go on the website and get the book, okay? I want you to have the book, Fire Prayers. I am not releasing it on Amazon. The devil is a lie. I'm not going to release it on Amazon. I'm going to keep it on my website. So may the blessing of the Lord keep you. May you reign and rule in peace. God has done a new thing for you. He's done a new thing for you. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things have become new. Behold, all things have become new. Yes, I will allow it for a 3-day grace because Jesus, everything, the work that Jesus did for us, he did it in 3 days. So until Friday, you'll be able to get the book for any seed, a seed of any amount that you sow into the ministry, okay? I'll send it to you. I'll send you a coupon code so you can go on my website and you can get the book. Let me see. I will not be on for prayer first thing in the morning. I want to work on my book for a prophetic interpretation. So I'm not going to be on for 5:30 prayer, but I'll be back on in School of Prophets. We have School of Prophets tomorrow for at 5 for those that are signed up. So, yes, I will be there for that. I just won't be for prayer at 5:30. And then Friday for Friday Night Live, I'll be back on, okay? 8:30 Friday night, okay? May the blessing of the Lord keep you. May the Lord, his face shine upon you. May he give you peace and victory in every area. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen. God bless you.